everyone, and we are back again with the entrepreneurial series between Indian Expats in Dubai and Business Conversations with Shubhika. And the guest today is none other than Dhwani Maheshwari, who is an entrepreneur, and she has come up with a beautiful, fantastic venture called Dip Dash Restaurant. It's very well located in Al Barsha, and the concept and the theme of the restaurant is fun, fusion, and pan-Asian. Welcome to the show, Dhwani. And it's great to have you here along with your inspiration, Mrs. Nilima. And it's beautiful to have you guys on the show today.
Thank you so much. Anand.
Thank you.
So Dhwani, tell us a bit about yourself.
So I'm a mother to two little kids. Of course, the only wife to my husband. And we live with our in-laws. I'm here to start up something of my own. And I'm really happy about it. And that's why we're sitting here.
Sure. And what was this inspiration about your beautiful restaurant that you have recently started called Dip Dash? What was the inspiration?
So the inspiration is sitting right next to us, my dear mother-in-law, Mrs. Nilima Maheshwari. And she's the inspiration behind this huge venture that we are now coming up with.
Welcome to the show, ma'am.
Thank you.
How do you feel with you know, her doing this venture and all of it? How is the feeling?
Yeah, I'm very excited and very happy.
And are you a great cook yourself, or is she a great cook herself?
So I would like to take the opportunity to answer this.
Of course.
She is a master chef. I mean, I've been living with her for the past 18 years. Yeah. I haven't had food that is so fresh, so yummy, out of the kitchen, on the table, which tastes absolutely amazing. She loves to cook, not just for us, for the little children in the house, but for friends, families, and you name it, and she knows what to cook.
So that's a wonderful thing that you said. And thank you so much for joining our show today. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Anil.
So why the name Dip Dash? Why you chose this name for the restaurant?
So Dip Dash in itself talks about the restaurant. Every food that we serve here comes with a dip, either in the plate or on the side. Also, these dips are the fun element in the food, hence dip. And dash means today's modern day fast food, which is healthy as well as fun loving. That's
wow.
Why I call it Dip Dash.
Wow, that's amazing. What a thoughtful concept. So when you were starting up, when this idea came into the picture, there must have been a lot of struggles, you know, throughout the process of setting up this. So tell us about that.
So yeah, it was not an easy decision to start up with a restaurant like this. We started up thinking we would move to a cloud kitchen, bring in the concept, let people try it, and then moved to a bigger concept. But it just so happened that we moved directly to a restaurant. And yeah, I did face a lot of issues in setting it all up from the scratch without any consultation. I wanted to get into right at the root and start it so that I know how to move in a longer way.
That's lovely. So where do you see Dip Dash 5 years down the line?
So 5 years from now, I don't see only Dip Dash as my brand. I'm looking at many more such vegetarian, vegan friendly, gen and healthy food concepts all around in Middle East.
That's lovely. I wish you're able to open as many ventures as you want throughout the globe. And talking about the entrepreneurs who are watching our show already and those who are struggling to set up their F&B business, what are some of the tips that you'd like to offer?
Yes, definitely to all the women out there, I would want to definitely put in some word here. A lot of us have been cooking at home and want to start our own venture of stepping outside, increasing our horizon, reaching to number of people around. So don't give in. You definitely should stand up, come up with a concept, move out, try your options with cloud kitchens or, you know, partnering with somebody, stepping out to some of the locations and bringing this to life. I would definitely say try in, because try till you succeed.
Great. That's a great takeaway for all the audiences out there. So I'm sure the entire menu list would be amazing. But tell us about few items which are there on the menu card and you want the customers to come and try as the first thing. And why?
Yes, definitely. So the menu that we have put up is after a lot of hard work, lot of trials, and everything in the menu is in-house. Even if it's the little of the dip, the little of the curries, the little of the sauces, everything is absolutely in-house. We have some amazing kinds of sushis. I don't think you would have ever tried. Like, we have the kinds with jackfruit, with eggplant, and all these are overnight marinated, you know, with flavors kind of sushis. We have a lot of different stuff. Like, we have a whole cauliflower which we marinate and steam bake and serve it with kale, which is mind-blowing. So yes, definitely that is one of the things that you should try. Something new that we've tried to introduce is the sushi cakes, which are three-layered rice with fabulous flavors in each of the rice and decorated like a cake. So a savory and a treat for people who don't like to eat sweets. We have pizzas for the little ones, again, very healthy ones, no white flour, millet, ragi based and gluten free, no cheese, and you can have them guilt free. We have our desserts which are with no refined sugar at all. So we've used replacements of sugar, which could be a cane sugar, a jaggery sugar, and no white sugar. We have dim sums, fun-loving ones, because we've used the color element. Now here the color is not the food color, it's the color of vegetables. So we have purple color, green color, and yellow colors, and these are vegetable colors that we try to make the dim sums with. We have rice and noodles. Again, the noodles are not made of white flour. We're using the buckwheat, the udon noodles, which are the healthier versions. We're not using cream in any of the food. So we're trying to replace the milk products and the cream with coconut milk, coconut cream. And I'm sure there's lots more on the plate that everybody could try as per their taste bud.
Wow, such an elaborative menu. But what would be that experience that people are going to take back home once they come to the restaurant and have the food?
So the experience that our customers will have over here is the different flavors, the freshness, and the food that they've never had before. And we don't stop here. This experience can be carried back home in the forms of dips and the curry paste that we have off the counter, where a person himself could become a master chef and serve it to their guests, friends, and families who come home.
So Dhwani, what's that one final message that you want to put out to all the customers out there?
And I would like to invite each one of you to come here and try our guilt-free, healthy, drool-worthy, modern-day food and unbox something vegetastic.
Thank you, Dhwani, for introducing us to this beautiful concept of your restaurant, which is Pan-Asian and Fun Fusion. Thank you so much for coming and joining the show today.
Thank you, Anil. Thank you so much.
And that's how we come to the end of this beautiful entrepreneurial session. And don't forget to follow and subscribe to Business Conversations with Shubhika and Indian Expats in Dubai. Thank you. Bye-bye.